Hi, I'm Kris Scherm. I'm the global director for this Cutmaster Plus series that you see here today. So the 30, the 50, the 70. Right now I'm going to go over the 70 and all of its details, right? So out of the box, it's going to come with a generous consumable box. Everything that you need for cutting, gouging, shielded cutting, unshielded cutting, even comes with a standoff guide should you want to do that. So we're going to turn the machine on. It's going to go through a startup menu, and the machine comes included with a 400 volt, three phase, 32 amp plug. That's what the 70 uses. Now, if I were to disconnect my torch, it's going to give you a communication. So the big, beautiful, bright TFT screen, that's communicating with you. So instead of giving you, you know, numbers and letters and different communication codes that you have to decipher, we're using pictures instead, right? So if I disconnect my air, same thing. You're going to get a picture that tells you, hey, you're missing your air. Plug that in. So now that I'm ready to go, I've got 70 amps on the front of the machine. I can see that clearly. The other menu, simple single button control knob. I can choose either expanded metal or solid metal, right? So expanded metal would be something like grate material, right? Something that's got holes or gaps in it. I'm also going to use that setting for gouging. 2T and 4T is, 4T is if I pull the trigger, I can let go of it and the arc will continue to go as long as it's connected to the plate. And then I can tap it to go off. The reason I would want that and the reason it's so convenient is for semi-automated applications, right? You don't want to have to stand there and hold the trigger down while, say, your pipe beveler or track cutter is cutting. You can just tap it on, tap it off. Really nice feature to have in a plasma. And last but not least is a gas purge. You want to apply about 7 or 8 bar, no more than 9 really, to the back of the machine. It's going to use about 6 bar for an outbound pressure. It sets that automatically for you. So there I go. I've got 70 amps. Let's put some PPE on. So be safe. Use your glasses. If you're going to be cutting, you want to cover your skin, cover your hands. I like using an auto dark hood, and I'm going to set those settings for cutting. I'm going to set it to about a shade 7. If I'm gouging, I'm looking a lot more at the brightness of that arc. I'm going to set it to an 11 or 12, right? So got it set to shade 7. Tighten that up there. Got my gloves, and let me show you real quick the rated capability of the machine. This is what I'm going to cut on. So piercing cut on this machine is 20 millimeter. So 19 millimeters, 3/4, 20 millimeters, a common plate thickness here in Europe. So you're gonna have 20 millimeter plate, and then 38 millimeter is actually the common thickness on the edge severance. But typically it's double whatever your pierce capacity is. That's what you're gonna have for pierce and max severance, okay? So let's get a cut going on that. Put my gloves on. System's already ready to go. I've got my 70 amp cutting nozzle in the surface, in the tip. There we go. Let's do a cut. Beautiful drop cut. Man, that 70 is so powerful. That is awesome. So typically, especially in plasma, if you travel just a little slow, you might get a little bit of draw sticking to the bottom, but it pops right off in plasma cutting. That's a beautiful cut. So let me see what a severance cut looks like on this 40 millimeter. So I'm waiting for that arc to pop through the bottom. I see that. Now I'm traveling slowly forward. I know I'm getting through the material because I can see those arcs coming out the bottom of the material at about a 15 degree angle. I'm traveling at a nice, consistent, slow speed. As I get towards the end, I'm going to start angling the torch just slightly so I can get the bottom of that cut to catch up. I'm going to pause my travel speed forward here and make sure that I carried through that cut. I wanted to make sure I carried through that cut at the end. There's going to be some dross at the bottom, but that's going to pop right off. OK, Okay, so you can see the dross on the bottom. I can see my striations, right? The line that's coming at that angle, that 15 degree angle, right? That dross is gonna pop right off. So let me get a piece of metal here. We'll use this. Okay. That way you can see the difference in the two cuts there. So there's my rated pierce and cut capacity, the thickness here, and there's my max severance capacity. So you can check that out. That's in mild steel. Now, if I were to cut some different materials, stainless, aluminum, I'm gonna slow that travel speed down about 15%. And typically I'm gonna reduce the cut thickness capability as well by about the same, 15-20% at the most, right? So if I was cutting really thick stainless like that, I'd have to reduce that thickness. Let me do a hole. Piercing a hole is not difficult, especially with a 70. It's such a powerful machine. So as I pierce that hole, I wanna set the torch at a slight angle, and I'm gonna come down into vertical. Since you're there in the camera, I'm gonna point the angle this way and come down into vertical. Let's pierce a hole in this material here. Okay, ready? Right through. Now I'm gonna travel around the circle. Around we go. Circling back where I was to finish out that hole. So there you go. See right through that, through the hole there. You can see where the dross needed to go. It went that way and not on my torch, right? So you can see my torch stayed nice and clean, right? So that's what that technique does for you. It allows those sparks to exit out at that angle and not right back up onto your torch. So there you go. There's the pierce in the rated pierce and cut capability of the machine. That's 20 millimeters. And then there's the edge start on the thicker material. Let's cut some stainless. I pulled that stainless out and I want to cut some aluminum. All right, so here's some thicker aluminum and stainless you might encounter. Let's do a cut on that and see what it looks like. Man, I love the power of that machine. That is incredible. Here's some aluminum. Beautiful drop cuts. Gotta love it. Okay. Aluminum and stainless looks quite different actually than the mild steel, right? So in aluminum and stainless, you're not getting the benefit from the oxygen that's in the compressed air we're using, right? So compressed air is the air we breathe. It's got about 80% nitrogen and 20% oxygen. Well, that nitrogen is gonna react to that stainless and give you that nitrided edge. That's what that darkened edge looks like on stainless. That's not weldable. You're going to want to grind that before you weld it. Same thing in aluminum. It gives you a very porous looking surface. You're going to want to grind that before you weld it. But other than that, man, that's, wow. Those are beautiful cuts on those types of materials. Okay. So that's the different types of materials. The processes though that you can do is also cutting or gouging. Like I mentioned before, when I gouge, I want to switch this over to expanded metal mode, right? That allows me, if I'm gonna stretch the arc longer and I lose the connection to the material, I can just bring it close again and it starts that gouge again. So let me show you, since I'm in expanded metal mode, I'm gonna do a cut and expand a metal first, and then I'm gonna switch the nozzle over to gouging and let's do a gouge. So let's show you what expanded metal is. I'm gonna pull the trigger one time, go across all those gaps. Super easy. I love that, right? So there's your expanded metal. Pulled the trigger one time, it's going to start and restart that arc each time it encounters that expanded metal. Now, if I switch this nozzle over, so that was my cutting nozzle, right? So I'm going to take that cutting nozzle out and I'm going to put, this is a size B, and I can see it sketched on the side of that nozzle. I'm going to set that in there. That's the only thing I'm changing, right? Makes that easy. So now gouging, what gouging is I'm removing the surface of the metal. Maybe I've got a weld I've got to gouge out, or I've got a piece of material that I want to weld prep. I want to put a gouge in it or a bevel in it along an edge. So let me spray the sparks this way again. I'll show you two different style gouges. Okay, so that's two styles of gouges. So the first one that I did was just a straight push. So as I brought that up, I'm just keeping a very shallow angle and I'm pushing that arc straight. That angle is kind of determining my depth. Then the width of it is determined by motion. So if I do a U-shaped motion or a V, a circle, right? You can be quite creative with your shape in order to widen that gouge out. So there you go, there's cutting, gouging, expanded metal. Really, really powerful machine. And for all that power, it's only 16 kilograms, right? So it's a lightweight machine, strong, durable package, easy to work with, very powerful, as you saw with the piercing cut on 20 millimeter. Go check it out at your local distributor. You're gonna love this machine. Go get you one.